I'm in a fast car, would that be like NASCAR? Molly in my jeans, I feel like Shiloh, bitch, that wild card. These pussy boy act hard, knowing that ain't not hard. They gon' steal my flow and then they some of that shit not bars. Yeah, now I'm all in, why these bitches I keep falling.
We've gotten used to of thinking of the name Intel as being synonymous with CPUs. After all, they invented the x86 architecture, and even though they've gotten some spirited competition recently, they've still been the dominant name in PC CPUs for much of the history. But a new challenger has appeared. Now, I'm not talking about AMD, but rather Nvidia, who is better known for being a power player in the graphics space. I guess Intel kind of invited this challenge. You've probably heard about their plans to compete in the GPU arena in the near future. But regardless of that, the encroachment Nvidia has been signaling this move for years. You see, although many customers are used to thinking of Nvidia as a graphics company, the days of them relying on selling graphics cards to gamers and workstation users as their dominant source of income are actually long gone. Nvidia has been investing in enterprise and data center applications for some time now. And while Intel is still the big name in server CPUs, the fact that cloud AI is such a quickly growing field has given Team Green an opportunity to make major improvements. As we all know, Nvidia's bread and butter GPUs are highly parallel chips, making them an excellent choice for the kind of number crunching needing for machine learning and neural networks. In fact, Nvidia's revenues from its data center businesses reached nearly $2 billion in the third quarter of 2021, well over double the previous year. But that doesn't mean CPUs don't play a critical part in these workloads. That's where Nvidia's upcoming AI-focused CPU codename Grace comes in. Currently, Nvidia is offering AI-oriented systems that feature their own GPUs but have CPUs from third parties and even AMD. But when Grace lands, hopefully in 2023, it will be, in Nvidia's own words, more tightly coupled with the system's GPUs, making it potentially appealing to companies that use cloud machine learning, enabling Nvidia to possibly ditch CPUs from its competitors, capturing more of the system value for themselves. And we haven't even gotten to Nvidia's even bigger power play. Its proposed purchase of ARM, the world's leading designer and licensor of mobile chips. Although the chip inside your phone isn't ARM branded, chip makers like Qualcomm and Samsung, even Apple, lean on them, as ARM-based chips have been popular for mobile application in large part because they're so power efficient. But they're also incredibly versatile and flexible, put their feet behind their head type of thing. Apple's new ARM N1 SoC has made waves of competitors to Intel and AMD's best. And even the world's current fastest supercomputer is also based on ARM. Now, pump the brakes for a second. It isn't a sure thing that Nvidia's acquisition of ARM will go through. ARM has produced designs for many companies that directly compete with each other, giving them a reputation for being a Switzerland-like neutral business. And the proposed merger could undermine this perceived neutrality, especially given both Nvidia's massive amount of market power and reputation for not playing nicely. And on top of that, authorities in the UK, ARM's home base, are concerned that the sale to a foreign company could cause national security concerns. But regardless, the outcome, Nvidia has actually built ARM-based CPUs in the past. Famously, the Tegra X1 chip that powers the Nintendo Switch, and the company is clearly looking to a future where it can further incorporate ARM into its own designs. Recently, it came out that Nvidia was working with MediaTek on an ARM CPU for a new Nvidia gaming laptop, potentially called the Shieldbook, complete with GeForce graphics. Gamers on an ARM laptop? I'm not ready for this. So while we don't know if this foreshadows an Nvidia desktop CPU to compete with AMD and Intel, it does show that Nvidia isn't afraid to explore some uncharted territory which could turn them into a big household name such as Intel in the future. Who knows, maybe Nvidia gets so dominant that Jensen will switch up and start selling green leather jackets, and I'll be the first customer. No, I'll not. But you will be the first to hit the like button, and also don't forget to subscribe.
Bitch, I'm in a fast car, with that bit like NASCAR. Molly in my G's, I feel like Shiloh, bitch, that wild card. Deep pussy, boy, act hard, knowing that ain't not hard. They gon' steal my flow, and then they some of that shit not bars. Yeah, now I'm all in, why these bitches, I keep falling, falling. Got this money, now I'm ballin', ballin'. Bitch, I'm in a fast car, with that bitch like NASCAR. Cause I'm haulin'.